Attitude is attitude. I hope all you understood what is attitude and attitude. See here, when we had seen a personality with a disability in a way of, in a physical way, if we had find any people, you know, some people, they will irritate. It's not it, see. But if you have a goodness in you, at least show a little bit of mercy. Or else completely you avoid them. But you don't have any right to comment or speak anything about their disability. That may be mentally or physically. It is wrong, children. Now, in this lesson, we have discussed about a personality of Nick. Right? What was his disability? He has a disability called phocomelia. Okay? Means he did not have arms, means hands and legs. He had a small foot. It is like a small foot on his left leg. That small foot only had helped him to play football and golf, and he had become a good surfer. What is meant by surfing? Okay? A game which we play on water with the help of a board. That is called surfing. He was a good surfer. Nick, you know, is a good surfer. Even though he has this disability, physically he had become a famous surfer. Not only in India, not only in Australia, not only in America, even all over the world. When he was born in 1982 December in Australia, Melbourne, he had born. But completely he settled in Los Angeles. Okay? With the help of that small foot, he called that, just funnily, he used to call that as small foot as chicken drumstick, because it used to look like that. It's a small, funniest thing he had commented himself on his body. He had called himself as a chicken drumstick. We had stopped up to page number 4. Now I'm going to continue the lesson from page number 4. Just look over the textbooks. His parents decided not to send him to a special school. A decision he said was very hard for him, but which may have been the best decision they could have made for him. His parents, see, as he had these disabilities, you know, they decided not to send him to school. Because even though he goes to school, there is no use. So, Nick had felt very happy with the decision. Actually, that was the best decision my parents had taken for me. He felt very happy for the decision. When Nick was born, his father was so shocked that he left the hospital room to vomit. His distraught mother could not bring herself to hold him until he was 4 months old. His disability came without any medical explanation, a rare occurrence called phocomelia. And Nick and his parents spent many years asking why this cruel trick would happen to them. My mother was a nurse and she did everything right during her pregnancy, but she still blamed herself, he said. It was so hard for them, but right from the start, they did their best to make me independent. Actually, see here, what was the, as according to the God, our fate goes. When Nick was born, you know, his father had come to see him. When he had seen his son, his father, he was unable to see his son. He came out of the hospital to vomit. Nick was born like that. Just imagine, students, when a boy had born without any arms and legs, and that too a small boy, just how horrible it was to see. And his mother, she was a nurse, and during her pregnancy she had taken a lot of care. She had of course she was in a medical field, and that too was a nurse, so she had taken a lot of care about herself during her pregnancy. But even though he had got this disability, so many times, you know, their parents used to struggle a lot. Arey, God, why aren't we did? Sometimes it happens in our houses also. Our parents will pray to God. See, what wrong are we doing? Why you are giving us these problems? See here, the God will test the right people. God will give the problems to the right people. God will test to the good people only with many problems. See, this is God's will. He will test our patience. Right? So, here, when they had been praising the God like that, he had seen and until he get 4 months, his mother could not hold him in her hands. He was like that. He was a small boy. He was like a flesh. But he don't have shape at all. He doesn't have any shape. So his mother did not hold him until he get 4 months. And his father had gone out of the hospital when he was born to vomit. See, any parents, it is a curse. It's not that just feel yourself, students, how horrible it is to be a parent when their child was born like this. So it was so hard for them, but right from the start they did their best to make me independent. But even though they did not leave him, they did not take any hard decision. They felt they tried to make him independent with these many disabilities. Physically, you know, he had a disability also. His parents had supported him. My dad put me in water at 18 months and gave the courage to learn how to swim. I also got really into football and skateboarding. I totally loved the English Premier League. Nick's father was a computer programmer and accountant. He taught his little son how to type with his toe just at 6 years old. His mom invented a special plastic device that meant he could hold a pen and pencil. Despite the risk of being bullied, his parents insisted Nick on attending mainstream school. It was the best decision they could have made for me, adds Nick, who later achieved a degree in financial planning and real estate. It was very hard, but it gave me independence. Nick, who was teased and bullied, had an electric wheelchair for mobility and a team of carers to help him. I was deeply depressed when I was 8 years old. He said, I went to my mom crying and told her I wanted to kill myself. I felt cold and bitter. I hated God for doing this to me and was terrified of what would happen when my parents were not there to look after me. I could brush my own teeth with a wall mounted brush and wash my own hair with pump action soap. But there was so much that was impossible for me. So when he was 18 months, you know, his father had made him to learn swimming. At the age of 18 months only, he learned swimming. And also his mother had supported him in many of the things. His father was a computer programmer and accountant. And at the age of 6 years, he could type, right? So he learned how to type with his toe. He had a small toe, no? Right? On his left leg. With the help of that, he started learning how to type. And he did not feel any sense that he had this disability. I could not read. But his mother, she prepared a stick. With the help of the stick, you know, by holding here, with the help of a stick, he can hold a pen and pencil and he could write on the board also. He could write on the board. See, the support of their parents. See, children, this shows the support of your parents. Whatever you are, you may be deaf, you may be blind, you may be dumb, or whatever you are, the people who will be always behind of you are your parents. See, even though Nick's parents, when he had born in this way, they had not left him. Always they had supported them. And also his mother, you know, she had done a good thing, is that you should learn something. You should have some degree with you. That's why, with that reason, she had sent him to a mainstream school. He had gone to a mainstream school. With that, what happened, you know, he had taken a degree in real estate and financial planning. He had taken a degree. Even in studies also, he was not backward. He was very good in his studies, even though he had this disability. He had taken a degree in financial planning and also real estate. He had a degree. But to go to mainstream school, he needed the help of carers. Some carers will be. So, see, all children, the fingers of us are not equal. Like that, how all the people in mentality will be same. That's what attitude is. How I told in a part of personality development, I told you. our way of speaking physically and mentally, right? Some people, you know, if we have a disability, they will criticize them, they will discourage them, and they will irritate them, they will use to tease them. So Nick also had felt same insult in the school when he went to school. Then, you know, one day he went to his mother and he cried that he told his suffering in such a way that I would like to kill myself. Why, ma? Why I should live like this? So better I'll try to die, but I could not live like that. But his mother had supported him every time. She had, even though he had these disabilities, he could brush himself, he can take a bath of himself. He did not depend on anybody. But he used to say some things that, of course I can do this, but there are a number of things which I could not do without these parts, you know. There are a number of things, so how could I lead? So at the age of 10, Nick tried to drown himself in the bath. But luckily the attempt was unsuccessful. I felt there was no purpose when you lack purpose and strength. It is hard to hold on, he said. But with the help of his religion, friends and family, Nick managed to pull through to become an international symbol of triumph over adversity. When I was 13, I read a newspaper article about a disabled man who had managed to achieve great things and helped others, said Nick. So at the age of 10, Nick had committed suicide himself. Means he tried to drown himself. Okay, but he learned something at the age of 18. So that did not help him to die. And he lived at the age of 13. He tried to commit suicide. He tried to drown himself in the water, but the attempt was unsuccessful. He could not die because, you know, he was a good swimmer. How could he die? Even though he drowned, it supports him to survive, is not it? So his attempt was unsuccessful. But at the age of 13, he read about a personality in a newspaper. Even though that man also was physically, he had a disability, but he was living. So when he had seen him, Nick was inspired. This is inspiration. Inspiration means, you know, for example, when two people were there, one person, you know, he lost one hand, and the second boy had lost two eyes, right? So what the first person should feel happy? Are that man, he did not have two eyes, at least I had one. So this is called hope, right? But we should not feel ourselves that, are, come on, I have this disability and I should die. If we feel like that, we could not live in the world, students. So always our hope, our confidence levels makes us to live and to do anything in the world. And here in this lesson, Nick also, he tried to commit suicide. Okay, he tried to drown himself. But even though the attempt was unsuccessful, at the age of 13, he inspired by a person, he understood the value of the life, and his thoughts completely changed. He decided, I should do something in my life. I realized why God had made us like this, to give hope to others. So what inspiration he got from him? Why God has given like this? He put a question to God, no, to inspire others, that God had made them like that. And it was so inspirational to me that I decided to use my life to encourage other people and give them courage that the article had given him. I decided to be thankful for what I do have, not get angry about what I don't. So from that age, you know, at age of 30, he did not blame the God why the God had given him such disability. He used to take that an advantage and he started giving hope to others. He started inspiring others. Okay? I looked at myself in the mirror. So when he had stood before the mirror, he started using some words. Listen, students, you know what the word is, right? That I have no arms or legs, but there will never take away the beauty of my eyes. I wanted to concentrate on something good that I have. The challenges in our lives are there to strengthen our convictions. They are not there to run us over, said Nick. In 1990, Nick won the Australian Young Citizen of the Year award for his bravery and perseverance. See here, once he stood before the mayor and he started talking himself. See what he did not have? He did not have legs, arms, right? He was physically injured. But he had beautiful eyes. So I had these beautiful eyes. This is my advantage. And he thought, see here, which I don't have, I don't bother about them. Which I have, I'll feel proud of them. And also, with this inspiration, he had motivated number of people. He as a good speaker, he inspired many people and he had given hope to others. And also, he had received from Australia, where he was born, he had received the Young Citizen Award. And for what he had received? For his bravery. For his bravery, he had received the award. And once I was in a car and a girl at traffic, lights was looking at me. Interestingly, she could only see my head. And I said, decided to do a 360 degree spin in the car seat to freak her out. Her face was like, "Who? What is going on?" She sped off really quickly. Nick began traveling the world, and in 2008, he went to Hawaii and met the surfing master Bethany Hamilton, who had her arm bitten off by a shark when she was 12. "She was amazing," said Nick. "She taught me how to surf, and I was terrified at first. But once I got up there, it felt absolutely fantastic, and I caught some waves pretty well." Nick quickly learned how to do the 360 degree spin on his board, a feat that got him on the cover of Surfer magazine within 48 hours. No one has ever done it in the history of surfing. But I have a very low center of gravity, so I have got pretty good balance. He has visited different countries all over the world. The football fan is now a motivational speaker and has traveled over 24 countries speaking to groups of up to 110,000 people. He moved to Los Angeles 2 years ago in 2007 and plans to continue to travel the world. "If I fail, I try again and again and again. If you fail, are you going to try again? The human spirit can handle much worse than bitter ice. It matters how you are going to finish. Are you going to finish strong?" said Nick. "I tell the people to keep on getting up when they fall and always love themselves," he said. "If I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done." Okay, and here are some words. Body structures and looks are inborn. We did not choose our makeup body. We need not take pride or feel ashamed of our looks and body structure. Pride and shame comes from our behavior. We respect people and people respect us for our skills, behavior and qualities. See, our lesson is over, children. See here, he had his interest. He is a very good spinner. He is a good spinner. At the age of, what made his interest to go into surfing? He had become Bethany, he was a surfing master. At the age of 12, with the shark, it had bitten her arm. It had bitten her arm. So she lost her arm, even though she did not stop surfing. So Nick went to Bethany to learn surfing from her. He was inspired by her. He was inspired by her. So he started learning surfing through her. And he used to do 360 degree spin, even though the waves were very fast. See how it was very difficult to do surfing without arms, without legs. Even though he was physically, he had disability, he was a good surfing master. He was a good surfing master. And that to that inspiration, for that he had chosen a personality of Bethany. He was inspired and he had learned surfing. And also, he not only apart from a football player, as a golf player, and also he was a huge fan of English Premier League and a good surfer. Apart from all these qualities, he was a good speaker. He inspired many people. His last words were "At least if I one person with my physical disability, even today I was like this, my job was fulfilled." So the last words are that beauty and also look is not a matter. Our behavior is very important. Our qualities are very important. Physically you are injured and mentally you are injured, it doesn't matter. What is important in our life? Our way of talking, our behavior, our character, this is important. So students, it is very important. At the end of the lesson, if you read the words, you know, physical appearance is not a matter when we are living in a society. What is important is that attitude is important. Our way of behavior with others is important. How we are approaching with others, whether they may be physically handicapped or mentally handicapped, this is important. So don't neglect the people. If you have seen anybody in your circumstances, whether they may be physically disabled or mentally disabled, try to help them. Try to recognize them. This is important. Okay? So, did you inspire by me? Okay? And this lesson is an inspirational story. It is an inspirational story. I hope all you understood. And as we finish the first lesson, you have a glossary in page number 6. And if you go through the lesson once also, it will be a beneficial one. Because you could get one passage from the lesson. So after my explanation, if you go through the lesson once, it will be a good advantage. And I'll give you a homework. Just note it down. What you know? Just write a short description about personality development. Personality development. Maximum try to write in 10 points. Of course, if you had understood this lesson, this helps you a lot to write about that. Okay, make a good use of it. And we'll meet in our next class with a new lesson. Thank you, children. See you in our next class.